dare you follow me?
I've come to speak to you.
I am ill. Do you understand? You are the reason I am ill.
I apologize. Nothing could be further from what I wished for you. That is why I wanted to follow you to Milan to see that you are well.
That is the reasoning of a capricious child. You can't do this.
I heard what you said, Giorgio. I've come to tell you. I'll keep my distance. Stay out of your path. But I can be nearby. I can be there quietly, waiting.
And this, you think, will make me love you?
No. No, I am doing this because I love you.
Well, my heart feels nothing for you. How many times must you hear this?
This has nothing to do with your heart. This has to do with your eyes, what you see. If I were beautiful, if there were ample flesh on my bones, if my breasts were large and full, if I were soft and warm to your touch, you would feel otherwise.
No. Your appearance is no excuse for the way you behave. My feelings towards you are the result of your relentlessness, your constant selfishness and insensitivity.
I'm sorry. No one has ever taught me how to love. I know I feel too much. I often don't know what to do with my feelings. You understand that, Giorgio, don't you?
Fosco, you have to face the truth. Please, you have to give me up.
Loving you is not a choice, it's who I am. Loving you is not a choice, and not much reason to rejoice, but it gives me purpose, gives me voice to say. Life for yours, Giorgio? Would she? I would. Happily. In the end, you will finally see what is beautiful about me. Do you want me to move to another compartment?
We're getting off at the next stop. I'm taking you back. You're freezing. Cover yourself up. You want to get sicker.
The moonlight makes even this landscape look lovely. Look over there. There seem to be faces in those rocks, smiling at us.
A month, a week, a day.